You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in the fields of science and technology, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreya Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Since time immemorial, Indian festivals have been celebrating the richness of India's vibrant culture and portraying the beauty and significance of our colourful rituals. Recently, the Goa Carnival was celebrated in the western state of Goa with great pomp and show. Take a look. One of the few carnivals in Asia, the Goa Carnival was recently organized with full fervor in the western state of Goa. The festival was flagged off by Pramod Sawant, Chief Minister of Goa. Beautifully decorated floating parades pass through five different cities of Goa, the best of which will be awarded.
Wishing all the people of the Goa for the happy carnival. Always we celebrate the carnival in very good mood. So I think the Goan people should enjoy this festival. All the tourists should enjoy this festival. We say the Viva Carnival.
Locals and visitors throng the streets along the Mandovi River in the capital city of Panji to get a glance of the float parade led by King Momo. King Momo is considered as the king of carnivals in Latin American festivals. Each year, a King Momo is selected for the carnival. This year, Shalom Sardinha was selected as the King Momo. Confluence of colour and culture, the carnival celebrates the onset of Lent, the 40-day period of fasting and abstinence in Catholic culture.
Message is very loud and clear. Carnival is a celebration, it's a festival, it's a traditional festival of Goa, and therefore each one of you all should enjoy to the fullest. When we say enjoy, it means eat, drink and be merry. That's all I ask of y'all. Enjoy it to the fullest, because the next time y'all will get carnival, it's 2021.
One of the few carnivals organized in Asia, the history of the Goa Carnival is more than 500 years old, when Goa was a Portuguese colony and was introduced to the Catholic culture and traditions. A riot of energy, colour, extravagant dances, positive vibes, music performances and unmatched exuberance. The carnival shows off the vibrancy of Goan culture, which is mixed in with a few hints of its Portuguese heritage. The carnival is a popular cultural event and is a big tourist magnet that attracts tourists and visitors from not only India, but around the world.
The experience here is very, very beautiful, very nice. It seems to be like Germany, but the weather is also very nice over here. So, very nice feeling.
We've just arrived today. It's our first time in Goa. And we heard about the carnival, so decided to make sure we see it. And yeah, it looks interesting.
the carnival provides an insight into the vibrant Goan culture and celebrates ancient Goan traditions that hold a major space in the history and formation of the state. India has always been a land of great saints, assimilating in its fold various cultures and thoughts from time to time. It is a land where Sufism has not only flourished in its true spirit, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. Today, we take you to the Urs commemoration of Hazrat Sayyid Shah Murshid Ali Al Qadri in the Midnapur district of West Bengal. Take a look.
Every year, a special train from Bangladesh comes to a halt at Midnapur in the West Bengal state of India. A large number of Bangladeshi devotees alighted from the train to attend the grand Urs ceremony of their revered saint, Hazrat Sayyid Shah Murshid Ali Al Qadri. The train service was started in the year 1903. This year, a contingent consisting of 2,321 devotees came to Zora Masjid in West Bengal to commemorate the 119th Urs of their beloved saint.
People from all religion, not only the Muslims alone, people from other religion, say Hindu, Muslims, Hindu, the Sikhs and other castes, they do come to wish their prayers over here and it is fulfilled. That's why they do come every year to show their gratitude and to show their happiness in this Urs Park. So it's a very honor and pleasure. And we are very happy to be a part of this Urs Park.
Thousands of devotees were sitting in the premises of Zora Masjid, eagerly waiting for their turn to seek the blessings of their saint, popularly known as Maula Pak. The Urs of the Sufi saint is one of the most auspicious occasions for both Indians, especially those living in West Bengal, as well as devotees from Bangladesh. People from all faiths, irrespective of their class, creed and religion, came to attend the holy commemoration of the saint, who was the 32nd descendant of the Prophet of Islam.
We are celebrating 119th Holy Urs Park, Urs anniversary of His Holiness Hazrat Sayyid Shah Murshid Ali Al Qadri Al Baghdadi, commonly known as Maula Pak. He is the 32nd descendant of Prophet of Islam, Hazrat Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, as well as 19th descendant of the greatest Sufi saint, Hazrat Abdul Qadir Jilani. His ancestors came India from Baghdad Sharif of Iraq near about 250 years ago.
Thousands of people from across the world, hundreds of people from different parts of the globe have gathered here to seek blessings of Maula Pak. Maula Pak has spread the true message of Islam. People continue to seek his blessings and they come from different parts of the world. There's a special train which comes from Bangladesh every year on this holy occasion. May Maula Pak continue to keep his blessings on us. And during his holy lifetime, Maula Pak has shown several miracles to show his proximity to Allah Pak.
During the Urs, a big fair in Meena Bazaar was also organized near the holy shrine. Stalls were beautifully decked with different kind of sweets and several other items for the devotees.
সমস্ত ধর্মের লোকেরা এখানে আসে সমস্ত ধর্মের লোকেরা এখানে আসে এখানে জান ভরে এনাদের দর্শন করে জান ভরে দর্শন করে জান ভরে ওদের মনে যা ব্যথা সেটা ইয়ে করে প্রে করে করে দোয়া মানে প্রার্থনা করে যে হয় যেন এখানে কোনো ধর্মে নিয়ে নেই খ্রিস্টান আসছে বা মুসলিম আসছে পাঞ্জাবি আসছে ইয়ে পাদ্রি আসছে সবাই সবাই সব ধর্মের আসছে বেশিরভাগই সব মানে বাংলাদেশি আসে আর বিদেশ থেকেও ফরেন থেকেও বিভিন্ন ধরনের লোক আসে
Mawla Pak was one among those Sufi saints who have been propagating the message of peace and harmony since ages. Their numerous teachings continue to bind people together, no matter which faith or community they belong to.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Indian President Ramnath Kovind hosted a grand banquet for Donald Trump on Tuesday at the Red Sandstone Presidential Palace, concluding the US President's two-day visit to the country. Trump was accompanied by his wife Melania, his daughter Ivanka, and her husband Jared Kushner, as well as other US dignitaries. Trump also met with Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Vice President Venkaiah Naidu, cabinet ministers, senior journalists, and other eminent personalities from India. Earlier in the day, Trump was given a formal state welcome at the palace with a 21-cannon gun salute and a red-coated honor guard on horseback on a smoggy day. Scores of Indian as well as international artists gathered in northeastern Guwahati city on Saturday for a tattoo convention. The convention, dubbed as Neon Northeast of Nation Tattoo Festival, and its motive is to put Assam state on the map of artistic tourism, said an organizer.
ये first time ये northeast में हो रहा है और India का भी और बाहर का भी India से बाहर से भी चार पांच country इधर में आया है तो इसका जो motive है to promote our tourism, to promote the new art form. और इसमें हम लोग काफी इतना मने अच्छा response मिला है.
Guwahati resident who got inked in his favorite footballer, Cristiano Ronaldo, said he always wanted to get the tattoo but couldn't because of safety concerns.
मुझे बहुत मजा आ रहा है and I'm very happy. और मुझे tattoo बनाने का पहले से शौक था लेकिन मैं बना नहीं पाया लेकिन इस बार मुझे अपॉर्चुनिटी मिला बनाने का सो मैं यहाँ पे हूँ.
The three-day festival that began on Friday hosts artists from UK, Nepal, Russia and other countries.
Moving on, the 7th Washoku World Challenge was organized in Tokyo, Japan, inviting chefs from all across the world to showcase their culinary skills in making Japanese traditional cuisine Washoku. And in another section, we will show you how Japan's company, Impact HD, is expanding Japanese services in India and all across Asia. Take a look.
Traditional Japanese cuisine, Washoku, is simultaneously simple and complicated, plain and sophisticated. It is salty, sweet, sour, slightly bitter, and full of umami flavors, and equal emphasis is placed on beautiful presentation. The Washoku World Challenge is a cooking contest for chefs of Japanese cuisine from all over the world who are passionate about Japanese food and are continually striving to deepen their knowledge and expertise. The 7th contest was organized by Japan's Ministry of Agriculture, Forestry and Fisheries with participation of foreign chefs. The theme was texture and mouthfeel. 5 chefs joined this final competition with cooking skill of Washoku. Washoku is registered on UNESCO's Intangible Cultural Heritage List, raising the government's hopes of enhancing its global recognition, attracting more foreign tourists, and boosting exports of the country's agricultural products.
今年は17の国地域から80人を超える方々に応募いただいて、そしてあの5人のファイナリストということになりました。まさにその日本の食文化の真髄みたいなものをいろんな国の地域の方が理解をなさって、で、それを自分の国の食材と、それから日本から各国にしてみれば輸入された日本オリジナルの食材を使って、で、文化を日本の食文化をいろんな異なる文化のところで表現すると。
In Bangkok city of Thailand, Japanese food is very popular and there are many Japanese restaurants. Jaran Dipuk is chief chef of Nanohana Japanese restaurant. He is the winner of the Washoku World Challenge
2015.
เข้มงวดมากแต่ถ้าชาเลนเจอร์มุ่งเน้นไปที่การแข่งขันการตัดสินใจที่จะประเมินทักษะความสำเร็จของวาชกูเวอร์ชาเลนคือความสำเร็จธุรกิจขอบคุณครับ
Japanese cuisine he cooks is very popular with Thai and Japanese customer and Nanohana has become a famous Japanese restaurant in Bangkok.
海外で日本産食材を使っていただけるレストランとか小売店を日本産食材サポーター店として認定する制度4500店舗が世界各国に認定をされているという状況です自分の国の消費者にどう伝えるかっていうのはその国のシェフが一番お詳しいと思いますので和食の技術を学んだシェフの方々が食材の良さを伝えられるからこそ取り扱ってみようと思うスーパーが出てきたり買ってみようと思う消費者が出られたりあのレストランに行ってもう一回食べたいと思っていただけるってこういう循環につながっているというふうに思います
Wang Weiping, a chef from China, won the competition. Foreign chefs convey the charm of Japanese food culture and washoku in their countries. Moving onJapan's impact HD company is developing Japanese service in India and Asia. India has been attracting attention as a huge market for businesses in various fields. Under these circumstances, Impact Holdings, which is a major component of its retail distribution, Real Store is one-stop, over-the-counter business partner that provides field marketing services, is developing convenience stores in India.The name of the store is Essentials. This store sells a variety of food and household goods as a convenience store.
カフェチェーンがやってるですね、コーヒーの豆だけ売ってる小売店っていうのがあったんですね。フレッシュ&グランデと。で、そのお店が約400店弱ございまして、これを我々の新しい合弁の会社に、店舗を現物出資するような形で移管してですね、約400店舗を一気にコンビニに変えていこうというのが今回の今進んでいるプロジェクトの第1弾でございます。結構おしゃれで綺麗なお店なんですね。でインドっていうのは人口13億以上いて、でアッパーミドルって言われているような年収が200万、300万以上あるような方が3億人以上いると。でそういう方々をターゲットとした、安心安全で非常にこうなんていうのファッショナブルで、そういうお店を作ってですねあのお店いいねとすごくクールでかっこいいお店だよねというようなことでそういったアッパーミドル層に向けたお店ですねこういったものをですねご提供しているということになっています地元のそういった方々にもすごく期待をしてもらってるんじゃないかなというふうに思っています非常に難しい市場です例えば物件を見つけたりだとかさっき言いましたキラナというような小さな小売店がインドでは主流の小売ですねこういったところを転換していこうというところには我々もいろいろ知恵を絞ってですね単純にお店を変えていくだけじゃなくて例えばデリバリーを中心にやっていこうだとかじゃあオリジナルのフードっていうのはどういうものが必要なのかこれもインドってやはりコールドチェーンがまだなかなか確立できてませんので例えば冷凍でなるだけこの食品ロスがないような形のチェーンってどうやったら作れるのかこういうものを模索しながらまずは400店舗のチェーンを2020年中にですね作ろうというところですけども非常に大きな市場で ある意味ブルーオーシャンみたいなところがありますので今のところはですね我々そう確信しながら一生懸命展開しているという状況になります
A hallmark of India is its diversity. Its citizens are of a heterogeneous mix of different religious communities and cultural backgrounds. People from different religious communitiesWork tirelessly to strengthen the secular bond of our nation. One such person is Mohammad Sharif of Ayodhya, who was recently awarded with the prestigious Padma Shri Award for spreading the message of communal harmony through his work. Have a look.
Mohammad Sharif, an 82-year-old man, is suddenly a cynosure of all eyes of Ayodhya.Always been respected and appreciated by his close ones,
Sharif is now being endured by citizens all around the country. Among the list of Padma Shri awardees this year features the name of Mohammad Sharif, who has been honoring the unclaimed dead bodies for the last 27 years. Sharif has performed last rites of at least 25,000 dead bodies of Hindus, Muslims, Christians and Sikh according to their religion.
हमें जरा सम्मान में नहीं अभी तमाम हिंदू भाइयों के साथ ही होती सब थी दिया जलाने को दिया जला दे मतलब नहीं तो हाथ में लगा दो टीका कुछ नहीं एक जरा सभी नहीं मेरे हिंदू भाई ने हमारी शादी की
शरीफ बिगान हिज मिशन 28 इयर्स अगो व्हेन हिज सन्स बॉडी वाज फाउंड अनक्लेम्ड एंड अनअटेंडेड सिंस देन He decided to give a proper burial to every dead body, irrespective of any religion or caste. It has been 20 years now, and locals have given domination to Sharif for his work. He had also been invited in Bollywood actor Aamir Khan's popular television show, Satyamev Jayate, and had been recognized for his deeds.
बहुत अच्छा काम हो रहा है कम से कम आदमी का निगाह ही नहीं हो रहा सबको अपना हाल हो जा रहा है
मोहम्मद शरीफ चचा जिनको कहा जाता है अयोध्या में आज की डेट में लगभग हर कोई इनको अयोध्या में जानता है अभी हाल ही में हमारी भारत सरकार ने इनको पद्मश्री सम्मान से नवाजा है इनका कार्य निसंदेह बहुत ही उत्कृष्ट है
इट इज ड्यू टू पीपल लाइक शरीफ who are propagating a great message of communal harmony that India continues to be the land of peaceful coexistence and harmonious concurrence.
Art exhibitions play an important role as they portray the emotions of an artist and act as a mirror of the society. With an aim to reach more people on painting and to promote the culture of art and sculptures, An exhibition cum sale titled Urban Challenges was organized in Siliguri. Have a look.
Art expresses emotions that are difficult to express otherwise. It takes us a step closer to our inner self. Many artists in the city face the challenges of urban living. To promote theme-based art, group of contemporary artists called V10 organized a 3-day long painting and sculptures exhibition cum sale at Ramkinkar Hall in Siliguri in Darjeeling district of West Bengal. The exhibition was organized under the theme Urban Challenges.
We have this aesthetic aspect, we have this emotional self, and there is this machine life. This mechanized, highly mechanized living conditions, you know. So what we see, you know, gradually the emotional self is challenged, you know. So we don't get to express ourselves. We are bottled up. We are stifled. So I guess people, there should be a balance between this machine and this emotional aspect of human life.
A number of paintings and some sculptures of famous artists across the country were at display with various mediums. A total of 11 artists showcased their work in the exhibition. In one of the art pieces, the artist shows how humans are tied with wires and smartphones. These artists interpreted their take on urban challenges in their own way. The artist depicted loneliness, depression, pollution, water scarcity, environmental degradation through their work. The exhibition brought many painters to share the challenges faced by being an urbanite. Many art lovers and visitors were seen admiring the beautiful artworks.
सिलीगुड़ी में ऐसा उद्योग पहले होता था, छोटा छोटा ऐसा उद्योग होता था, लेकिन ये जो है इसको और भी बढ़ावा देना चाहिए, हम लोग सबको आना चाहिए और भी लोगों को, और इनका ये जो पब्लिसिटी का ज़रूरत है इस।
About 50 paintings along with sculptures were displayed in the exhibition. Organizers are of the view that organizing an exhibition like this will not only promote the painting culture, but it will educate the society to protect the environment.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@ANIN.com. I'm your host Shreya Savajay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.